Myself, Subhashni Sapkale, from the Department of Chemistry, New English High School and Junior College. Welcome students. We are delighted to introduce online lectures for HSC students. The main purpose of this lecture is to enable every student to prepare himself or herself thoroughly at home. Each and everything will be explained in detail. We will start with the chapter 1, that is solid state. For our convenience, we have divided the chapter into different sections. First lecture will be the introductory lecture, which will cover the basic concepts of this chapter. What is a matter? Anything that occupies space and has a particular mass is called matter. Everything around us is a matter. We are also a matter because we have a particular mass and occupy space. We have learned that the three physical states of matter are solid, liquid, and gas. Any state of matter can be changed into another by changing conditions like temperature and pressure. As you all know, water exists in three different forms, that is ice, liquid water and water vapor. At 0 degrees Celsius, water exists in the form of ice. As we increase the temperature, this ice gets converted into liquid water. Till 100 degrees Celsius, it exists as liquid water. If we increase the temperature further, it will get converted into water vapor. The existence of a particular state of matter depends upon the two factors, that is interparticle force of attraction and the second is temperature. The interparticle force of attraction is the attraction between the atoms, ions or molecules. When this interparticle force of attraction is very strong, then the substance exists in the solid state. If it is weak, then the substance will exist in the liquid state. If it is very weak or negligible, then the substance will exist in the gaseous state. The physical state of the matter is the result of interplay of this interparticle force of attraction. And this interparticle force of attraction depends upon the temperature. At relatively low temperature, solid is the common state of matter. By raising the temperature of the solid to its melting point, it gets converted into liquid. And liquids on heating to their boiling point transforms into the gaseous state. As we all know, gases, liquids and solids are made up of atoms, molecules or ions, but behavior of these particles differ in three phases. Let us recall some of the properties of solid, liquid and gases that we have studied in 11th standard. Now the solids are closely packed structure, so the particles are very close to each other. Particles cannot move freely as they occupy fixed position. The kinetic energy of these particles are very less. In case of liquids, particles are loosely packed and the particles can move a small distance within the liquid. And the kinetic energy of this particle are moderate. In case of gases, Particles are very far away from each other, so the particles are in continuous random motion and the kinetic energy of the particles are very high. In case of solids, the shape and volume are fixed. They have a definite shape and definite volume. In case of liquid, they have a definite volume, but they take the shape of the container in which it is kept. In case of gases, they do not have a fixed shape and fixed volume. In solids, the particles are very closely packed, so the slight increase in temperature will result in small volume increase. In case of liquid, the particles are loosely packed, so the slight increase in temperature will result in moderate volume change. But in case of gases, they are very far away from each other. So the particles are very far away from each other, so slight increase in temperature will result in significant volume change. In case of solids, the intermolecular space is very less, so it cannot be compressed. Almost it is impossible to compress. Practically impossible to compress. But in case of liquid, the intermolecular spaces is very small, so the particles can be compressed to some extent. But in case of gases, the particles are very far away from each other, so because of the large intermolecular space, they can be compressed to any extent. So these are some of the important properties of the solid, liquid and the gases. Now you must have understood that solids have definite shape and volume, and interparticle force of attraction is very strong and it is incompressible. On the basis of the arrangement of the particles in the solids, solids can be divided into two types. Number one, that is crystalline solids, and number two, amorphous solids. Look at the structures carefully. What is the difference between the two structures? In the first one, the particles are arranged in an orderly manner, and in the second case, particles are arranged randomly. Let's start with the difference between crystalline and amorphous solid. Crystalline solids have a definite geometric shape due to the orderly, regularly arrangement of the constituent particles. That means there is a regularity and periodicity in the arrangement of the particles. Amorphous solids have irregular shape due to randomly arranged constituent particles, but they do have a short range order. Crystalline solids are called true solids because it is difficult to break the regular arrangement due to strong intermolecular force of attraction. Amorphous solids are called as pseudo solids because they resemble liquid in many ways. Like liquid, it flows slowly on heating. Another important property is the melting point. In the 11th standard practicals, we have done the determination of melting point. So you all know what is melting point. Crystalline solids have sharp melting point because of the regular arrangements of the particles. Amorphous solids, they don't have the fixed melting point. They melt over a range of temperature. Suppose a substance starts melting at 100 degrees Celsius, it will go on melting till 150 or 200 degrees Celsius. One of the most important property of the crystalline solid is anisotropy. Now you know what is anisotropy? It is the ability of the crystalline solid to change the values of physical properties when measured in different direction. That is called anisotropy. Crystalline solids except those having the cubic structure are anisotropic in nature. In cubic crystals, all the three axes are of equal length and all the three angles are of 90 degree. So they are isotropic in nature. Amorphous solids are isotropic in nature. Their properties such as refractive index, conductivity are all independent of the direction of the measurement. Now, if we can say some of the examples of crystalline solids, as we all know, ice, salt, metals, these are all the examples of crystalline solids. And tar, glass, plastic, rubber, etc. are all the examples of amorphous solids. Observe the figure carefully. Can you see the two type of circle? It represents the two type of constituent particles. Now tell me whether the arrangement of the particle is regular or irregular. It is regular. That means it is a crystalline solid. Is the arrangement of the particles are same or different in different direction? That is, see the direction of AB, CD and EF. Yes, the arrangement of particles are different in different direction. Now we know an isotropy is the ability of crystalline solid to change the value of physical properties when measured in different direction. We can understand by this figure. Suppose if we pass a light in AB direction, different set of particles will be covered. Similarly, if we pass light in the CD direction, different set of particles will be covered. So the refractive index will be different in the different direction. Similarly, electrical conductance will be also different. How? If we pass the current in AB direction, different set of particles will be covered. So the amount of current flowing will be different. Similarly, it will be different for the CD direction. So, the ability of a crystalline solid to change the value of physical properties is different. So, I hope you have understood the property of anisotropy. Observe the figures carefully and identify the arrangements of A and B. Can you tell me which one is crystalline and which one is amorphous? Yes, first one is crystalline because there is a regular arrangement of the particles, and the second one is amorphous. Similarity or dissimilarity in crystal structure of different solid is described as isomorphism and polymorphism. Now, what is isomorphism? Two or more substances having same crystal structure are said to be isomorphous. Iso means same and morphous means form. In these substances, chemical compositions has the same atomic ratio. Example, sodium fluoride and magnesium oxide. Here, the atomic ratio is 1:1. There are many such examples of isomorphism. The same atomic ratio and similar molecular formula or similar chemical properties are not enough to claim that this substance is isomorphous. If we take the example of sodium fluoride and potassium chloride, have almost identical properties, but their crystal structures are different. Now, what is polymorphism? A single substance that crystallizes in two or more forms under different conditions is called polymorphous. Here poly refers to many. There are many examples of polymorphism. In the lower standards, you must have studied the various allotropes of carbon. This allotropy is the result of polymorphism only. Now, carbon has three polymorphic forms, that is graphite, diamond and fullerene. Similarly, calcium carbonate also has two forms, that is calcite and aragonite. You must have heard about the silica also. Silica also exists in many polymorphic forms. In the next slide, you will see the images of the various polymorphic forms of carbon and silica. Many crystalline forms of silica are found in nature. Some of the polymorphic forms are given in your textbook, that is cristobalite, alpha quartz and beta quartz. This cristobalite is used in the construction activities. There are also many forms of quartz that are used in the construction and the various type of ceramics, etc. Carbon crystallizes into three polymorphs, that is diamond, graphite and fullerene. The properties of all the three crystals are different. As you know, diamond is the hardest known material because of the strong covalent bond. Graphite, however, has a layered structure. The layer of the carbon atoms can slide over another layer. That is why they are soft. Fullerene is the third form of carbon. Here, fullerene molecule consists of carbon atoms connected by single and double bond, so as to form a closed structure and it looks like a soccer ball. Let us summarize the lecture with some important points. Solid, liquid and gases are the three states of matter. Solids have a definite shape and volume, and intermolecular force of attraction are very strong in solids. Solids are of two types, crystalline solids and amorphous solids. In crystalline solids, particles are arranged in a definite repeating pattern and shows the property of anisotropy. In amorphous solids, particles are arranged randomly but they do have short range order and shows the property of isotropy. Similarity or dissimilarity in the crystal structure of different solid is described as isomorphism and polymorphism. Hope you enjoyed the lecture. Thank you.